Now, here are the contracts. You just put his name at the top and you sign at the bottom. There's no need of you reading that because these are duplicates.
Yes, a duplicate, thanks. Duplicates, Sam.
I say they're duplicates.
Why, sure, it's a duplicate, Sam.
Don't you know what duplicates are?
Sure, there's five kids up in Canada.
Well, I wouldn't know about that. I haven't been in Canada in years. Well, go ahead and read it.
What does it say?
Well, go on and read it.
All right, you read it, go on.
All right, I'll read it to you. Can you hear?
I haven't heard anything yet. Did you say anything?
Well, I haven't said anything worth hearing.
Well, that's why I didn't hear anything.
Well, that's why I didn't say anything.
Can you read?
I can read, but I can't see it.
Don't seem to have it in focus here.
If my arms were a little longer, I could read it. You haven't got a baboon in your pocket, have you? Here we are. Now I've got it. Now pay particular attention to this first clause because it's most important. It says the party of the first part should be known in this contract as the party of the first part. How do you like that? That's pretty neat, eh?
No, it's no good.
What's the matter with it?
I don't know. Let's hear it again.
Says the party of the first part should be known in this contract as the party of the first part.
Well, sounds a little better this time.
Well, it grows on you. Would you like to hear it once more?
Just the first part.
What do you mean, the party of the first part?
No, the first part of the party of the first part.
All right, it says the first part of the party of the first part should be known in this contract as the first part of the party of the first part. She'll be known in this contract. Look, why should we quarrel about a thing like this? We'll take it right out, eh?
Yeah, it's too long anyhow. Now what have we got left?
Well, I got about a foot and a half. Now it says the party of the second part should be known in this contract as the party of the second part.
Well, I don't know about that.
Now what's the matter?
I don't like the second party either.
Well, you should have come to the first party. We didn't get home till around 4 in the morning. I was blind for 3 days.
Hey, look, why can't the first part of the second party be the second part of the first party? Then you got something.
Well, look, rather than go through all that again, what do you say?
Fine.
Now I've got something here you're bound to like. You'd be crazy about it.
No, I don't like it.
You don't like what?
Whatever it is, I don't like it.
Well, don't let's break up an old friendship over a thing like that. Ready?
Okay. Now, the next part, I don't think you're going to like.
Well, your word's good enough for me. Now then, is my word good enough for you?
I should say not.
Well, that takes out 2 more clauses. Now, the party of the eighth part...
No, that's no good, no.
The party of the ninth...
No, that's no good, too. Hey, how is it my contract is skinnier than yours?
Well, I don't know. You must have been out on the tail last night. But anyhow, we're all set now, aren't we?
Oh, sure.
Now, just you put your name right down there, and then the deal is legal.
I forgot to tell you, I can't write.
Well, that's all right. There's no ink in the pen anyhow. But listen, it's a contract, isn't it?
Oh, sure.
We've got a contract, no matter how small it is.
Hey, wait. What does this say here, this thing here?
Oh, that's the usual clause. That's in every contract. That just says, if any of the parties participating in this contract are shown not to be in their right mind, the entire agreement is automatically nullified.
Well, I don't know.
It's all right. That's in every contract. That's what they call a sanity clause.
You can't fool me. There ain't no sanity clause.